I'm going to record. Since you're not doing your work on time, I'm recording. Okay, just let's go. So, suppose I want get unique. Sultan. Okay. Well, let me see the database. What is DBD? JCLD. Video DB. Okay, suppose these are two segments. Okay, this is first record, Sultan, third, fourth. So this I took for a training. Three people joined sometime back. Their name is Adarsh and Ravindra Singh. So I gave their name and inserted everything. And that training went for at least 2 weeks. Well, not 2 weeks, probably around 7-8 days. Every day we had interaction 1 hour. So here, let's use the calls one by one. Let me execute the programs I have. BAD get one. Okay, another thing I forgot to tell you. So let me ask this question. How many SSAs can you have in a call? What is the maximum number of SSAs? Is it one or many?
Many.
Many means how? What is the maximum?
No, I don't.
Okay, we can have one SSA for every level.
Right?
We can have one SSA for every level.
Okay.
So we can have one SSA.
15. So maximum 15.
The maximum 15, yes. City of London Corporation.
You are under which screen?
IMS.sourcelib. VAD get one.
Yeah, you are in working source section.
Yeah, I haven't moved. So we can have one SSA for every segment. Okay, every level. And remember, if you give more than one SSA in the IO area, it is going to have data of the lowest level. So you're understanding what I'm saying? You can, yeah. Suppose you can give multiple SSAs in a call. So you can give any number of SSAs, and SSA can be unqualified, qualified. So it is going to search for the SSA and place the cursor, hop here and there. Okay, it's going to hop, it's going to search, and then hop here from here to there. So, and finally it's going to stop at the lowest level SSA. And the data in IO area is going to be from the lowest level SSA, not from other SSAs. It's not going to have data from all the SSAs, all the segments. So here, it's a get unique call. Okay, it's a get unique call. So rental name is Dream Girl. Okay, probably what I will do, I'll just tell me what you want, then we'll write a program accordingly. So this is a, suppose I want who are the people who got this movie. Okay. I want the people
Dream Girl.
Who hired this Dream Girl? So what will be the call?
Call will be,
I want everything, all these three.
So get next.
See, as far as the IMS is concerned, there are many ways to do it.
Yeah.
Okay, but finding the efficient way is the challenge.
root and get next only. Right?
See, there are many, many ways. For example, you can start getting from here. I mean, yeah, see dream girl, then you have to start from here, but you have to stop here. The best way is, since we know the dream girl, see, if you know the value, it's always get unique. So if you know the value, it's get unique. If you don't know the value, it's a unqualified SSA. If you know the value, it's going to be qualified SSA. So since we know this value, say dream girl or 004, whatever, say assume you're dream girl. No one is going to remember this 004. So you're going to have a get unique based on the dream girl. Place the cursor here in root or enter.
Okay. Get then what you do? Place the cursor, right?
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Then you do a GNP.
Yeah. Get next P.
GNP within get next within parent till GE.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. Understood.
Okay. I'm going to write this.
I'll try.
You're going to try?
I'll try those things. You give me such kind of requirements. No? We'll discuss the requirements. I'll try to code them.
Okay.
This is one requirement and...
Okay, I have many requirements. Just hold on. I will...
Instead of you giving me code, those programs are already there, right? I'll go through them and I'll code myself. If you give me as many exercises as possible, right? I'll try to code them.
Okay, we'll just probably I'll write scientific people who got Dream Girl as a movie. So I'll write in exercise document here. I'll just write in notepad and give it to you.
Can you put the data here at the top?
Data, okay, here also.
It will be in a single notepad. No? Otherwise, you keep
the here? There. Then I'll remove this. I'll remove this. Okay. Okay. Next will be list all the movies in the video library. There are two ways to do it. I mean, there are many ways to do it. Two efficient ways to do it. One, if first efficient way is the best. Second efficient way. List all the movies in the video library. So it's going to be Avengers, Sultan, PKG, Dream Girl, Dangal.
Then we have to use get next.
Okay, that's good.
Get next and so I mean we have to. Access all the records, right?
Yes. Only the movie names.
Only the movie names, is it? Okay. Mm. So, only the root. So, GNP.
No, it's going to be get next, not GNP. GNP means just within the root.
Yeah, within the root only, right? We want only the within the root.
No, not within the root. We are going to have all the roots. See, there is no parent for root.
Yeah, right. Yeah, correct. Yeah, there's no way. So get next, but we should.
So you can straight away go for get next from top to bottom till end of database without SSA. Then you can find whether it's a rental segment using PCB status code, PCB mask. Then you can have the name. That is one way. You can top down, you can read everything. That is one thing. Second, you can have a get next with unqualified SSA as rental segment.
Only with the rental segment.
Unqualified SSA.
Okay.
Then end of database. Another way is, no SSA is required. You can use PSB with only rental as the sensitive segment. Then it is going to read only rental.
Only simple get next will get all
simple get next is going to read everything because the logical view of database is only rental as far as the program is concerned.
Correct.
So there are three ways. Okay. Okay, change the movie for video ID to Bahubali. I'm a video ID 3.
In the movie for the video ID. Then we have to use GHU.
That's good.
With 003. And then we have to, then the next call will be of replace.
That's good. That's right.
Okay. Bottom to top can we access, but from the root only, right? From the root we have to enter and then
From the root we can.
No, nothing.
And remember, if you delete a parent, all the associated children get deleted automatically. Like how you delete a base cluster, all path AX, delete one parent. You delete dream girl, it's going to delete all these three.
See, suppose there are. Suppose location wise, suppose there is a location like Hyderabad, Pune, Chennai, Mumbai, like that.
Okay.
So I want to get only the Hyderabad data.
You have to use if condition, or you can use the Hyderabad in the, you have to use qualified SSA.
Qualified GN, I would be using.
You can use qualified SSA. But remember, if you are going to use any qualified SSA, you are going to give the field name, but the field name should be in the defined in the DBD. So unless it is defined in DBD, we cannot use those field names in qualified SSA. So here,
can we not declare in PSB?
PSB we can give, but see, unless it is the field macro is given for any field name. As I told you earlier, all the field macros will not be there. Only specific fields will be there. So these are called search fields. Only if the field macro is present for a field name, you can use in qualified SSA. Other than this, we cannot do anything. We cannot give anything in qualified SSA. No, nothing is eligible. And in the qualified SSA, we are going to give this is a segment name, this is a field name, and then relational operator and value.
Okay. And one more thing, like when we compile this. Code, will be getting any field and copybook and all?
Copybook it will not be given. We have to give manually. Yeah, that's a good idea. Good.
I mean, just like DCL gen like that.
Yeah, understand. You are asking what I mean. I understand what I'm saying.
But that is not there.
As far as I know, that is not there. Generally, we create in projects because copybook it doesn't really make sense because. It is not going to give field names which we require. Second, most of them means storage is going to be filler, right? So we are going to fill finally. So if you go to project, there are 100 bytes, only two fields will be there defined in the DBD. Remaining fields will not be defined at all. So there is no point of generating copybook through DBD. Okay, here delete all the renter segments of movie Dangal. See, here I have given Dangal means you have to use Dangal as a search criteria, not 005.
Yeah, even Dangal also, it will be
in the search field.
GHU. And then delete.
No, it's not GHU. Movie should be there.
You want renter.
Only the renter. Yes.
Okay. GHN.
Okay.
And then the renter segments using the SSA, we have to delete.
GHN can be done, but that is not advisable. The better thing is first establish parentage here using GU or GN. It's going to be GU because we know the value.
GU.
Then do a GHNP delete. GHNP delete.
GHNP. Okay.
Get hold next within parent, delete. Get hold next within parent, delete. And do this till GE.
So first placing the cursor. Then the next call, second call will be GHNP.
And delete.
Third call will be delete.
Yes, GHNP delete together. GHNP success and together.
Okay, together we can do it.
Together. No, GHNP, not together means two calls, two different calls. GHNP, delete. GHNP, delete.
In a total three calls.
Total
two
three
calls will be loop.
Totally, there are five calls, in fact. Totally, actually, it goes for six calls. First, GU is going to place the cursor here.
One time.
Yeah, one time. GHNP, delete.
Two calls.
GHNP, two delete. Call. Two calls.
Five calls. Total and five calls.
Then, fifth, sixth GHNP, it's going to give GE.
GE,
then
end of...
End of segment. No more segment. Correct. Okay. Insert a segment. Render segment as given. Okay, for Bahubali as given below. So assume we are going to rent this out, and I'm giving along with the segment name just for a reference. Your name is correct, right?
Right. Bahubali is given. Okay.
Okay. Just insert a render segment. And say
for
you can,
Bahubali.
For Bahubali 2020.
It's a new one.
It's a new one, yes.
So. Directly we can use call with the insert.
No, we cannot use directly call with insert. Since we know, see, if you know a value, it's going to be a qualified assistant. If you don't know the value, here are all the movies, so it's not going to be qualified assistant, just an unqualified assistant. If you know the value, it's going to be qualified assistant. Here, what you're going to do, insert or enter segment. So if you want to insert anything, you're going to place the cursor in the parent. So since you want to insert or enter, so you're going to place the cursor in here, 003. So assuming this is completed, you understand?
Okay.
You're going to place the cursor here. Then issue...
In that case, we have to place the cursor at with the name Bahubali, so GU we can go.
Yes.
Okay, and then in the next call, insert.
You just insert with unqualified assistant.
Yeah, right.
It is going to work.
Suppose I want to completely insert a new one, say Saira movie. So then, how will be the calls?
So you can insert in a hierarchical fashion. That is better.
Hierarchical in the sense?
You can directly go on, keep on. First, you have to insert rental. I mean root segment. Then you are going to insert site segment. It is going to place.
Any call like get next or get you?
Nothing is required.
Directly insert call.
Directly insert, but make sure it's in sequence. If it is not in sequence, then get unique get next is required to place the cursor. If it is in sequence, see, if it is sequence, first it is assume you are going, let me write the sixth one. So I'm going to, you are going to insert these three. Or did I delete? Var 5. I deleted 5, that's fine. Insert the following values. Saira, right?
Yeah, anything, anything. Any new movie.
So assume you are going to insert two. So what you do, first you insert the rent root. So for inserting root, no establishing parentage is required. Because it, root, there is no parent for root. Once you insert a root, the cursor is going to be in the root. Now, if you insert a child, it's going to be inserted under this. So there are no issues. No parentage is required to be set explicitly. So if you're going to insert something, the full entire record, DB record, you have to insert straight away in a hierarchical fashion. It is going to take.
Okay.
You understand? So yeah, there's going to be three insert calls. Read, insert, read, insert, read, insert. In the first call, it's going to be segment name is going to be rental. You are going to give unqualified SSA as rental. Here in the second and third insert, you are going to give renter as the unqualified SSA. So you have to make sure, okay, you have to give data and tell, okay, this is the SSA. I mean, this is the segment name. Give data and give segment name also. In a hierarchical fashion, it is going to insert the full database record. Nothing else is required. Only if you are going to insert randomly, you have to place a position in the parent and then insert using a, give the data and segment name. That time you require to use a getUnique or a getNext call. You are going to use getUnique provided you are having a specific value. If you are going, you are going to use getNext if you don't know the value. So you are going to read everything sequentially. Then you decide in the program whether this value is correct or not. Then you decide, then you go on insert.
Yeah.
Just hold on. I'll give one more. Something came to my mind. I just suddenly stopped. Dangal, I'll delete, write it again. I think I have given one movie. Fourth. So this is the current status of database. Okay, this is the current state of the database. And you are going to insert six. Now six is there. Okay, what else I can ask? I know people who are dream girl movie. First all the movies. Change the movie from video ID 0 to Bahakuli. Delete all the retro segments. Replace, insert and then enter segment, insert a new record. Okay, insert a full record. Okay. And there's something called first, last. All these can be done only if. Okay. Okay. I have one more question. What is this field? These two fields.
Half payment like that we have discussed.
I think some date.
Yeah, half payment on that day, half payment on that day usually.
Okay, I can see, let us see the DBD. Then only I will know. Because I haven't written any structure. Give you DB. Or rent, okay, renter ID, movie name. return name, issue date, return date. Issue date, return date. So this is issue date, this is return date. Okay, I'll tell you. I'll ask this. I want to know when Ravindra Singh returned Avengers Endgame movie. This is the return date, right?
Yeah. You want to know that value?
Yes.
So?
Wanted to know when Ravindra Singh returned this movie. You know the answer. This is the answer. This is the return date. How do you find it? There are ways.
So first we have to call based on Avengers Endgame. So GU, set the cursor. And then again based on SSA, Ravindra Singh. After one cursor setting like based on the Avengers Endgame, can we again set a get unique?
We can again get unique means going to be reading from top and place a cursor wherever it finds the match.
Because one get unique will set the cursor at Avengers Endgame.
Okay, then I want to read this.
I want to place the cursor at Ravindra Singh. So one more get unique.
Not
for a renter.
There are two ways. One is place the cursor here, read everything
sequentially. But there can be a number of records.
That is one thing. And there are many ways to do it. There are F and L and a lot of other things. And the another way is get unique itself will know because we know the value of the parent as well as child. Use get unique with two SSAs.
Ravindra Singh and
Avindra Singh.
Yeah. So okay.
Both are qualified.
Two SSs directly. Yeah, right. Two SSs directly you can use.
So because there are two levels, right? And then
from my IO area we can pull this
data.
Yeah.
Okay, IO area is going to have only the renter segment data because as I said, you can give as many SSAs. I mean for every level we can give one SSA. It is going to hop from this to this. Cursor is going to hop. And it is going to stop at the last SSA, at the lowest level. And then the data in IO area is going to have only the lowest level SSA data. So Ravindra Singh, this one will be there. As you said, we can retrieve this. So this is enough.
Okay.
So what I will do, just share this document.
Yeah.
Just share this document. Save this. But so there are many ways to do it, and only thing is we have to find the best way to do it. That is the challenge. As far as IMS is concerned, that's where people